What's going on, guys? Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for checking out another video. To drag things out, but I asked the Holy Spirit to put into my mind the words so I could tell you correctly, reasonably, concisely, and in an understandable manner the topic which I will be covering. Now, it's very good if you already know about the Nephilim that are covered in the Book of Enoch and Chuck Misler's sort of hypothesis or theory on, say, for example, the return of the Archons or the return of the Nephilim and who they are, what the so-and-so Canaanite or something-something-ite Ninevite societies in the Old Testament is all about, and how they how they're interlinked with this whole thing that we call the Nephilim. Genesis chapter 6, verse 4, also mentions the Nephilim, but in the sort of mainstream, modern interpretation, understanding of who they are, it's not technically correct. God has shown me through personal experience and also, of course, information and research to be able to connect all the dots and to present to you the actual situation of how they influence and where they are in the world today. Now, long story short, they, as described in the Book of Enoch and also in Genesis chapter 6, verse 4, they are the offspring of the so-called sons of God, who are the, according to the Book of Enoch, the 200 watcher class fallen angel seraphims, i.e. Satan and company. By committing the grave sin of procreating with human women, whomever they wanted, as many as they wanted, they created the offspring called the Nephilim. I think they're also referred to in, as Raphaim and sometimes Eljo or something like that. They go by different names. And there's many different kinds of them. If you are familiar with Chuck Misler, his hypothesis and how he talks about it, obviously the Book of Enoch doesn't go into an exhaustive explanation as to what happens, but you're basically told that they mix the blood of the animals and humans and blah 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 and sinned against all the species that God had created, and henceforth they have all sorts of abomination, right? They have abilities that don't make sense to us normal folk. They are not, it's better not to think about it too technically or scientifically. It's much more mystical, magic oriented. I'm an engineer, a technical mind, I'm third generation engineer. Chuck Misler was an engineer. I find it non-constructive to see it from a scientific, technical point of view, because it kind of fights core logic. But they have the ability to psychically read your mind. Now, somebody said, I saw somebody on the internet once say, another YouTuber, pastor guy, that Satan can't read your mind because it said there's some passage that says that Satan doesn't know the heart of man. But note that the mind of man and the heart of man is two different things. Your mind is one thing and your heart is another. That's why God can, for example, Satan can, for example, tempt you with certain things, but it doesn't make sense to you because he's made an assumption about what sits in your heart, but you wouldn't say yeah to that because it's not what your heart desires, but he can read your mind. He does know what your mind is thinking. They also commune with what are called familiar spirits. Familiar spirits are spirits that are literally familiar with either your life or an area or something. And they're familiar with the way that your mind works, so on and so forth. They are still in the world today. They can look and talk just like anybody else. They can somehow master true form. And although they might not actually look like people, they can make themselves look like people. Or they literally just look like people. It's a whole slew of things. The thing that we know is the common gray alien from Hollywood and Area 59 and all the conspiracy theories. That's a Nephilim. That's one type of them. God showed me many of them. Many different types. Just like in the movies. It's kind of weird that they more or less kind of tuned it so well. I suspect that that they are not as ignorant as most of us, or they would have us believe, or most of us think. Yes, I am personally not just convinced, but informed by God that they run every government institution in every country. And they pretty much run and hold all the keys to the economic system and all that jazz. I have had the opportunity and the... Depends on how you look at it, right? Glass half empty or glass half full. But I have bumped into said Nephilim on occasion. Multiple occasions. I've seen that other guys on the internet talk about bumping into people whose eyes get all like black and they get all weird. Yeah, I've done the same. They're a type of Nephilim. There's also another type whose eyes become like cat eyes, like reptile eyes. That's another type of them. I'm just shivering a little bit because I'm standing outside and it's like, I think it's like -8 today. It's a really cold day out here. Beautiful though, isn't it? Check that out. Oh, blessed with such beautiful things from the mind of God. Now, yeah, they run the show. They modulate our perception of reality. All around us, it's like antenna networks. It's like cell phone coverage. They can seed thought into the minds of people. So at a moment when you think you're having, say, a moment of religious contemplation and you think, should I maybe go to church? Should I maybe start reading my Bible? Then boom, out of nowhere, depending on your volitions and how your mind is oriented to begin with, it might seed a thought of doubt. It can seed, or they can seed, different things. Or they can say, hey, what's your friend's going to say when suddenly you become a Bible thump in Alabama or whatever, right? So that's the work of the familiars. It's another thing for them to find people that have a certain talent. Now, it's hard for me to say what exactly they're looking for, but also they're looking for people with, say, charisma or influence or abilities. And let's say they also have a sexual deviation. Say they have a tendency to find children sexually attractive. They will recruit them. They will try to recruit them. That's why you'll see all these rumors about the pedophilia, the satanic pedophiles that run the world. There you have it. Now, God has told me that if you looked at my previous videos that go all the way back, you might have bumped into the one where I explain how I met God and how He presented Himself to me. And I'm always reminded that one of the first things that God had me know is that He loves me incredibly much. But he said directly after that, he said, but I love everybody like that. And I've had the unfortunate experience of being somewhat harassed by these people. And it can drive you to the brink of madness, actually. It's very frustrating. But God puts it into your spirit to share the truth that you know and to try to share that with them and tell them, hey, man, you know, God's waiting for you. Your birthright is right at the table. It's for you to take. Sin no more. Leave that thing and no one will judge you. You will be reborn, you know? And then the second you do that, out of nowhere, some strange other dude that winks real funny, makes a funny eye thing, shows up and tickles and entices them to sin again. But that's just how it is. And they're everywhere, man. They're in every town. They run everything. Check out Derek Prince. He'll tell you a little bit about how you can tap into the Holy Spirit's ability to sense their presence. Derek Prince Ministries. British, I believe he would be considered a pastor. But he talks about that if you see some of his talks on the internet. Okay, guys. That's about all the Spirit's got me to cover. I plan to make a few more videos about this thing, maybe. But check out the description. There's a few links on Chuck Misler's talk on the topic, because that's good background info. You should really watch that if you want to know what's up. And leave a comment if you want to know more. It'd be cool if you consider subscribing. I'd really appreciate that. And if you want to spread the word, hit that likes button or send the video out to a friend or somebody that might be interested. And if you want to know more specifically, just let me know, because I got mad boogeyman stories for you. Really, I do. And if you've had experiences like this yourself, I would love to contact you, because, or get in contact if that's what you want, because I think it's important to, yeah, to, like, you know, reach out to people that know what the deal is. All right, guys. Again, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Oh, yeah. And there's one more thing I totally forgot to mention. Reference the Book of Enoch. But God has basically put a curse on all the Nephilim. They don't get along very well in the pre-diluvian age before the flood. They ruled over all man and had us enslaved. And that's all the pyramid building societies of the past are beyond normal humans. So it's like playing chess against a world grandmaster and you just happen to be 5 years old and barely know how to read. So God turned his face to man on the planet Earth and he said, all right, fine. Boom. All the Nephilim will war against each other until they all kill each other off until the end. And so basically what I noticed is that after I read that, I noticed that I could instigate the same amongst them, because I can basically have them go into that modus where they're kind of like just looking at each other and get this bloodlust to like beat the daylights out of each other or whatever. And it's all just through this mental response, because if they're mentally linked with you, then all you need to do is be like, yo, who of you could kick each other's butt? Oh, yeah? Yeah, you want to fight about it? Like, seriously. And then next thing you know, they act all weird. It's just a curse, you know? It's God's magic. What can you do about it? So that's one way to tell if you ever suspect that they're around. I use it all the time. It's so trippy. All right. I had to add that anyways.